Hey guys, my name is Kiera McGinness, and this year I will be an assistant coach on the 14U Royal team. Just a little bit of background about me. I am currently a senior at Park Center Senior High in Brooklyn Park, and I'm the captain of my softball team.
And now Kiera McGinness.
I've played for many years, all throughout high school and everything, and I am a utility player. Today I'm going to show you guys an infield drill that you can work on by yourself or with a partner. So for this drill by yourself, you'll just need a tennis ball and then a hard wall. I would recommend either going in your garage or if you have an unfinished basement, something that your parents won't mind you throwing a ball at. Otherwise, if you are gonna do this drill with partner, I would recommend you can probably still use a tennis ball or a softie or a real ball if you're doing it inside. And then if you want to for either of these drills, you can eventually move up to using your glove. So what I'm gonna want you guys to do for this drill is that you guys are gonna be continuously throwing the tennis ball at the wall. And it's probably something you guys have more commonly done before, but it really works on the basics and the fundamentals of fielding your ground ball and working on your stride up to a ground ball as well. So this drill works on not only grounders, but it works on line drives, weird pop-ups, one-hops, all of that. It all just depends how you throw the ball. So you can start with for a decent amount of distance away, but you can work on throwing the ball high, low, right, left, backhand, and you can work on all of these things with just the tennis ball. And the closer you move, the harder the throw will be, so you can work on all these different types of ground balls. So you can start whatever distance you want away from the wall. I recommend starting farther back and then moving yourself forward a little bit. So what you're gonna do is just throw the ball, get it ready, and then up like you're gonna throw it. And then you just throw it back. And then you can throw it to different positions on the wall to give you different grounders. Okay, so for the other side of the drill, which is working with a partner, if you'd rather do that instead, then I would recommend starting with just your bare hands and not your glove, and then use a real softball. It's instead of throwing it against the wall, you're going to roll it to your partner so they receive the ground ball that way. And you're gonna do the same steps as approaching to the ball, picking up the ball, grounding it, and you're gonna still do locations, left, right, faster, slower, one hops, stuff like that. And then after you're picking it up, you should still be doing this with this drill and the last drill, is you should be reaching back like you're about to throw it, versus the other one, you could then potentially throw it back to the wall.
Can't take no chances with my love. Can't take no chances.